measuring devices and instrumentation. In measuring devices and instrumentation, we have already covered your spectrum analyzer, we have covered network analyzer, we have covered power meter, we have covered VSWR meter. Today we will see the wave meter. So suppose if you are going for your wave meter we are using it for measurement of frequency. Okay, and if you look for the type of wave meter, you are having absorption type cavity wave meter and you are having dielectric frequency meter. As long as your dielectric frequency meter is concerned, this we are using it in the lab. In the laboratory, you are having the dielectric frequency meter. Now, let us see your absorption type of cavity wave meter. In your absorption type cavity wave meter, there, if you are making the characteristic graph between your frequency and your output power, it will supplement. So, this is your frequency and here you are having the output power. In this, this is your maximum power and this is the minimum power and this is your resonant frequency. Okay. If you are going for the analogous equivalent of that one, so your analogous equivalent of the absorption type of cavity wave meter, it is your inductance capacity that are connected in series. So, this is your analogous equivalent of your wave meter. That is the result frequency. You can calculate the result frequency from the formula V by D whole square. Here, your A, B and D, these are the physical directions of your this wave meter, adjusted type wave meter. On the other hand, if you are going for your M, N and P, they are the modes. So, M, N, P, those are the modes and your A, B and D, these are the physical directions of your wave meter. Your wave meter. Say suppose here if you are seeing that you are having A, B and this is a D. This height, this is your D. Here you are having a bubbling hole. This is your circular cavity and here you are having a shunting plunger. So shunting plunger means here we can rotate it and if we are rotating we can change this dimension. We can change the dimension D. Okay. So if you are rotating it with this, your shunting plunger come down. Okay. And this D decreases. So as D decreases, your this resonant frequency can also change. So what we are having? We are having the control over your resonant frequency. So we can change the resonant frequency from your shunting plunger, from your shunting plunger. Okay. So we can rotate this one. So this type of thing you have seen